Okay, let's try this again.
Alright, gotta make sure I turn off that sound so I don't get echo. So, again, hope you're having a great day. Happy Sunday to you, or Sunday evening, Sunday afternoon, Monday afternoon. Hope you're having a great day. Today, what I'm going to be working on is step two of my promo art that I'm working on. The idea here is this particular character, I'm trying to give it sort of a similar feel to this other art I did, oh no, it feels like 2 years ago now. It might be 2 years. This art here. So, we'll do something similar here, and I'm not gonna have as much time from it as I had the last time. So I should have already done this, but this year is gonna be kind of a catching up year, and also a year where I start doing more of this type of stuff, cause I'm gonna start putting my comics on online. So, let's start. So this character, I finished actually making some adjustments to it. I flip it now, the character does not look tilted. I think his forearm size is fine. I had someone made a comment about that. So I think his forearm size is fine. He doesn't need to be really bulky. Most of what you're gonna see is worked out is his legs, even though it really doesn't matter based on his power level. So I think for now the overall sketch is fine. Well, actually I will say a note. This was based off this sketch here, which is also another sketch, so it's been modified. So now he's kind of looking down, but instead of looking down where it's more of a focused gaze like that, it's like that. Now, if you like that, then that's fine. And just let me know. I can possibly change it to that. So let me go over here to a reference photo. So he's albino. I think this character right here looks a little albino. He's very pale. I might use that as the base color. So essentially this character is supposed to be like the first African albino. I don't know if that sounds right. So what we're gonna do is, I have my overall background color here, and I'm gonna add, because this is gonna be about the tone that I want, because it's gonna be in space. And then we're gonna add all this other atmosphere type stuff in there as the background, and add some more stuff based on my Pinterest account, which I'll share here in just a second. But I have these other ideas over here on this Pinterest boy here. So this is what I'm going to use for us, like, to figure out what I'm going to put in the background, of course, of my character here, off to the side that I added to this pin as well. And I have one other board that I have over here. Let's see if it's an easy way for me to get to that. So I have quite a few boards. I have this board here and this board here. And let's open all three of those up in a tab. So this boy here is what I'll use as reference for my my characters for this universe. And I have this I'm gonna be using for to make sure I get the skin tone correct for African. I think she and him is close to what I need, because he's African, of course. And she's African, of course. So I'm going to be using them as reference. I really like this picture here. Kind of like a Street Fighter, Tekken, or Dragon Ball Z thing going on here. So I'm gonna open this one up. So I'm gonna probably be using this to get that tone right. It's this one I'm about to start working on now is the bass tone. So let's jump back over to my stream. So go over here, and I think I'm gonna use this because it's gonna be easier. Let me just duplicate this real quick. And I'm gonna make this, put this in a folder called the sketches. All right, drop all these in here so everything be organized. And what I really wanna do is make this white or lighter so I can see. I think there is actually a faster way to do this. Hold on a second. View window, the layer property. Layer color. And then we're gonna change this to a lighter color. Just to make it easy for me to use. So I'm gonna do this another layer now. Call this my flats. And that's kind of typical for me. Since it's comics, actually the easiest way to do this. Let me see if this will work. I'm gonna use my wand tool. Alright, it looks like they got most of it. Alright, and I should be able to invert that. And then we can be able to clean that up. Let's go here. I'm gonna subtract from this. Alright, so right now I'm just gonna establish the base color. And for this particular episode, I'm gonna try to keep them short. So this one, I'm just gonna be doing the base color and maybe laying down a little tone. Take this in a step-by-step process, which means it should be done in another one or two sessions. Depends on how it goes, if it turns out the way I want it. So, yeah. Remember, I don't do this every day. I think the last time I did one of these had to be a year or two ago. I did some for Inktober, other stuff, but nothing on the level that I want to do for this. So we're gonna do more of these this year, so there will be more streams and more opportunities for me to do this and get better at it. And possibly even be able to do a graphic novel or art book on this. Will include all the different characters from this universe. I think that'll be cool. And I'm gonna finish making that selection. Now with this character, it should be pretty straightforward because he really doesn't have much of a costume. There is another iteration of him with sort of like, I don't call it a cape, but something to go across his chest so his chest won't be exposed. I'm kind of thinking it really doesn't matter, but we'll see. The character design for this is real simple, because most of the original character design was a little bit more to it. I changed it. So I figured based on the character itself, the coolest thing about it, the character is its power, so why do I need to give him a super cool costume as well? A lot of times super cool costumes overcompensate for the character, it seems. Even with all his powers, he's still flawed. Because the depth of his powers is so vast. He's still learning. Even though he's been around for eons. And he looks like a young man, but he's really, really, really old. Gonna be interesting when people start to see these stories, how old these characters are gonna be. They're gonna have been around so long that a lot of the pagan gods that people worship from different areas in the world, he's gonna have been around longer than that, than those, and some of my other characters, before those actual things been in existence. And within this universe, it's gonna be some interesting takes on that stuff as well. I think that's all of it. Alright, so I'm gonna go here to my flats layer. I haven't even added any layers yet. So I'm gonna just steal this color over here. Let me use eyedropper. Actually, eyedropper is not gonna work. Oh, darn it. There it is. It's showing up. So it's not. It's kind of not as pale as I thought it was. Alright, so we'll use that as the base color, because that still is not as pale as I thought it was going to be. Set that to through. And we'll put the sketches on top. And now I can, should be it. Turn this off. Alright, that's good. So I'm gonna turn this down. Alright, we can lock this. Alright, so we need the hair and the undergarments. So we call this skin. We'll do one for the hair. And then we're gonna do one for the undergarments. We call it loincloth. All right, so here we just paint that in. And what we'll do is, but now we'll add this as a mask, but we probably end up removing it because we don't want to make it limited, but we want to sort of like limit it for now. looks a little shabby though. So we'll have to do some cleanup. We'll figure that out. Actually, let me do this real quick. Let me just do this on this version and see if we add a glossy invert on it. No, we'll just leave it like that for now. All right. Anyway, so let's go here for the hair. This doesn't need to be white, so I'm gonna use the same color. Let's go back to our color palette. Okay, that's our previous color. So now we should be able to lighten this up. Get something close to a white, but not really a white. Alright, so now I can go here to my, I'm gonna use a paintbrush. Alright, so now it's gonna be a little bit like paint by numbers. I'm gonna do it really loose. I just wanna get, since this is masked out, I just wanna get the outside. And the cool thing with Clipstudio is you can hit the C key and it'll give you a transparent brush. So that's really helpful. I'm just going to outline the area where this thick beard and mustache is going to be. So I usually color stuff is might be a little different than what other people do. So like I said, it's a paint by numbers sort of thing. That's how I do it. Everybody have their way of doing things. That's mine. So right now I'm just keep this real loose because I don't really have much to add here. So now let me just hide this sketch real quick and see if I got this pretty solid here. Just a little smoother. It wouldn't be straight anymore. I can go ahead and fill this. Okay, this is filling this the wrong way. Alright, that's not working. Let's turn that off. Well, that's weird. Why is it filling like that? Let's do it like this. We'll go here. Let's do this. Fill it. Do the same thing with this. Try and get this on there. Hair not to be so sharp at certain areas, at certain parts. I'm gonna do the same thing with this. That's not working. So we got the beard in there. Let's do the line claw. So like it's gonna end up being like a gray, a grayish blue maybe. Alright, let's hide this. Make sure we got everything selected. I think we're gonna take that all the way down.
So those are the flats. So now what we want to do is add in the tones. Now you can do this one or two ways at this point. If you're doing this for the comic book, you do all the tones over. You can either do it on another layer, or you can do it on the same layer. Even some of this paint stuff here, I got split up into three layers. It really can be done in one layer. That's how I did the other paint that I showed earlier. This one I'm doing a different way because I just want to try it out. For this case, just saw some here. Just trying to make sure this is right because I see that this is going behind. I don't think it's going to be that bad. Hopefully not. Okay, so what I want to do is I'm going to add in a tone layer. Alright, so I'm going to start with this here. I'm going to start with this being a multiply layer. And I'm just going to add in that seems a bit strong. So I need this. And I think I need the burn. I think they have burn in here. So that means it'll be one of these. Oh, we got color burn and glow. Glow would be for highlights. I think linear burn might be for the reddish color I want. Let's see. I need this to be darker. And let me test this to see if the color burn. Alright, color burn gives me that color that. The in-between color that I want with the same shade just needs to be redder. Let's see if I add a little red to that, what happened. No, that's too strong. So, select this color again. And we need to be a little bit more red. Go here. Yeah, it's closer to what I need. Okay, so this would be the color's blushes. And then this would just be for the tones. So I can delete this now. I actually repeat that in one more time. And turn it down a little bit. Okay, so I'll get for my blushes. This will be for my tones. I'll go back to select this one. And let me just select this blue real quick. Okay, I'll worry about that for my shadows. So we're gonna lay down some tones. So where we at far as time? Half hour. Okay, that's not so bad. Alright, so now you know what? I haven't established my light source. I might just use the light sources on this reference image. It's coming from this. Actually, I think the light will be coming from, let me do a reference layer here. The light will be coming from here, here, reflecting up here. Wait, I just noticed this over here. I'm coming from the back. So, I think that's mostly where the light would be coming from. So that means all this part would be illuminated on the edges. So I think that's what's gonna happen here. That's what I like. Alright. So let's jump back over here. Just noticed something with his hands I need to fix. So I'm gonna go ahead and see. Should I just use the brush? I'll use the pen because it's better. Why is the anti-alias down there? That's why it looked like that. Because my anti-alias was off. I'm going to go ahead and clean up this jagged line. I don't know why it's going to see us because it's not going to be zoomed in, but it's for my own sanity. Encounters music off. I ain't gonna sweat this too much. Let's get back to the tones. Go back to our brush. So since most of this is gonna be in darkness, I'm not gonna worry about but I need this to be a little bit more blue. And I need for it to be darker. Tones too. All these are going to be merged. Only reason why I'm keeping this separate now is I'm trying to get my tones together. Alright, this is too strong and just need to be on. Let's try softly. That looks. That could work. Bump it up a little bit. It looks like that blends in. Some of the areas are. This is supposed to be darker though. Thanks. Let's try to multiply again. Turn it down. All right, so I want to get this to the point where I can kind of like pull away from the original drawing and then just start painting. So once I feel like I'm at around that point, I can probably call the video. Let me see what this looks like after I'm done. Right now what I'm using is the blend brush. You can use the J key to get to it while you're in Clipstudio. And when you're painting, I wouldn't call it so much like a palette knife, but it could probably be close to that. It's pushing paint around to blend it. See what this looks like without the sketches. Alright, starting to define the shapes. So I need a little bit more of that blue in there. And then I could just have the image off to the side. As a matter of fact, I'll fade it a little bit more. So let's see less of that. Focus more on the. Let's jump back over to our oil brush. I don't want to put too much blue on this side. Got some. I'm gonna add a little, just a little red in there. This character really doesn't have blood circulate through his system, so I don't want to add too much in there because it's not relevant. Even though I know most human characters, you have to have some redness around certain areas, so I'll try to blend this with a little bit more blue. So now I could go over here and select this color because it's the color I was using. See, this is coming in. Oh, I got the blend on it. Alright, so let's just look at that. That's where we at. So we got our flats down and some of our tones. We got to blend that. And from there, I think we have a good basis to start from to finish working on our painting. We can just about see the character. I think the only thing that needs to be defined a little bit more is the eyes and the nose. As far as the overall body, the hands might need a little bit more detail, but that's mostly just the fingernails. Legs are pretty detailed, need to be blended better. Okay, well, the next video I'm gonna be working on will be finishing out whatever other little details that I wanna add, like I see here, and the loincloth. I need a little bit more detail there before I can cut off the line art. And then maybe a little bit more detail in the hands. What else? And in the face. And once I have those details, I won't need this drawing anymore. I can probably put this off. And matter of fact, I'll do that now. Let's go ahead and make a new view. Workspace. The window. I'm gonna put this off to the side here. Alright, so let's do this. We're gonna save this version. And then we're gonna save just a version with the image. So let's hide the flats. Pull the sketches up. Unlock that. Bump that all the way up. Pull this to the front. And let's save this as a JPEG. Pretty sure I already did this, but they already have this. So I'm gonna go here and I can close this version and I can open that JPEG. I think this is an updated version. So I'm gonna split this window here so I have that for the next time. And then I go back over here, pull it back down 30%. Lock it. Back on my flats. And then I have my drawing I can work with. So here I can see it a lot better. Actually, it looks about the same, just one is darker. I leave that on there because then that'll give me a better tonal idea as far as like a skin tone, because right now it looks really, really dark. And the idea is the flat, you need to really look almost like that as it's skin color. Skin color is closer to that tone, because right now it looks a little bit too dark. Let me duplicate this real quick. I have this version and I'm going to go here and use my saturation. Actually, I need to use the levels. Alright, so let's see if I make this lighter. Yep, that's better. I don't know why it was so dark. I wonder how this looks on another monitor though. Let me go new window. I don't pull this on another monitor because my other monitors have a different look. Monitors are not in sync, which they should be. Okay, this looks close to about the same. So let's save this. I think this version right here is just too dark because it doesn't look albino if you skin is that dark. That might be good for some of the darker tones, so I'll see if I need it to be that dark. But I don't think so. Let me hide the sketches now. Yeah, so that looks more like what. So only thing is the edges, which I want to highlight. It's probably gonna be a little blue. I'm gonna add some blue on the edges just to add the outline and just to quickly go what I'm talking about. If I go to this one here, why is it not selecting that? Let's save this. Alright, let's do this again. Why are you not selecting it? Alright, let's go here to one maybe. Oh, it is selected. Or maybe it wasn't. I don't know. Alright, so right here, a quick way for me to do this using, let me go here, add another layer. And I'm going to just call this the, outline. Alright, so I'm going to use this blue that we use right here. Select the paintbrush. And let's paint the edge. I'm gonna get the edge. So I'm trying to get this. Trying to get the edge where the skin is. To create like an outline. Actually, I did it pants too. And I can go in here, clean this up, make it better. It's more or less where the skin meets the outline. Right now, I'll just keep it a little loose. And I can also bring it up into this area too, if I want to. Define that, where is that sketch at? Define the outline for the chest and where it separates. And then I can always use the C to bring it back. Then I would actually, to make this better, just go in and, again, like I said, use the C and just go in and clean it up. Right now it's really loose. So then, let me just add a couple more of these lines real quick, and you'll see the benefit of this. The whole point in this, I don't know if I want to call it technique, But this can be used later as a reference to make this more 3D. If I use it or not, but that'll be helpful to outline or to separate certain pieces that you need to project out. I have more of a three-dimensional feel. So I really wanted to go in and do this. I'll do that for the fingers too. And do it over here, but it's a little bit thicker over here. Wait a minute, I just noticed that this is okay, I think I see something's happening here. Let me finish this first. Let's go back over here. I'm just using a seat right now to erase back some of the lines so I can tighten that up if I want to. And I can do this to my heart's desire, but I wouldn't want to do it, because then I'll be doing that forever. But you get the point. Alright, so I just noticed that this, let's deselect this. This is not subtracted here. So I need to go back here. I'm gonna invert this. And I think it's this one. Let's go here and use the eraser. This is, and this is for the hair, so that's not gonna do anything. Maybe it's the tones. Yeah. Okay, so let's see. E-brush. Let's see. Alright, so yeah, we need to use that on this. Blushes, probably not. Definitely need to use it on the outline though. Alright, so let's just erase that. Go here. Erase that. So the idea with this is to be able to use this later to help make the edges pop, and you can blend it into the color. Let me see, I'll use a darker color so you can see it. But you see here now the edges will pop a little bit more, help creating that separation. And then depending on the color you use, it should blend in. Who is it? Let me see if darken is the one I want to be using. Nope, it's not. I think it's either the highlight. Nope, it's not highlight. Oh, usually if we had a burn option, we would be using burn. I'm trying to remember which one is similar to burn. Color dodge. No, that's the glow. Subtract is burn. So subtract is our burn here. And as you do linear burn, that's going to still use the same color. Subtract will give you a tone of it. And then you can pull it back if you need to. And then you can always use this C to erase it back. But this can be done towards the end so you can get the look that you want. But you get the idea here. So what the next stream is going to be about is me not using this anymore. I'm pretty much going to be using the rest of this to maybe even with some of the color add some of this tone that's going to help it pop like how I'm talking about here. But the goal is to get it to look more realistic, and we're not going to be using that color, we're going to be using this color. So this is going to be a little extreme, so it'll be more like something that's even lighter. But it'll help it create that separation, so when I turn it off and just have this here, you can see that. Let me go here, bring it back a little bit. On this dark background, it'll help it. Certain parts of it to stand out, but you'll see. Again, this is the flats with the tone, some of the tones. The first session was just doing the drawing, which I had, you can see off to the right of the screen. I'm gonna be using that in reference for the next session, and that will be to add more detail as far as the tones and do more blending. And then hopefully that will get us to the point where we're almost done with it, and then we can start adding in our atmosphere for the character to give him the little pocket universes and other elements that's going to be all around him and even going through him at some point, because this character can do a lot of different things, and I want to try to display that just subtly by the scale of the character and the things that you see that's around the character. So I think that's all I need for now, and that's it for this stream. For those of you who have any comments, please leave your comments. If you have any suggestions, leave a suggestion in the suggestion box. If you have not hit that follow, hit the follow. Also hit the notification bell so you'll be notified for any updates. And that's all I have for now. Follow me on any of my other social media. If you want to see any of my other videos, check out my YouTube channel. And that is also under the same name, Art with AMRB. Or you can just go to AWAB. And that's the same across all my social medias, Twitter, Instagram, Facebook, whatever. Until next time, you guys have a great Sunday, or whatever day you're looking at this, you have a great day. And until next time, peace.